Now, the transport sector has been smacked by the slowdown in the U.S. economy, and there are even signs that Chinese demand for such things as coal is waning. So what's really going on? For details, let's ask Jason Seidel, expert analyst at Dahm & Rose. Jason, good to have you with us. Thanks for coming in. Let's start with this China news, because I noticed in your report you do this weekly roundup of what's going on, the things that affect the transport industry. And you and your colleagues over at Dahm & Rose, you've been looking at what's going on in China, and you say might be a little bit of slack demand for coal, right?
Yeah, well, you know, the export coal volumes have been really picking up towards China. We see a lot going out of the port of Vancouver, and that had been going at a really a breakneck pace. And when you look at a sequential basis, there was a market slowdown, about a 20% slowdown in the bookings for Chinese ship orders for coal. So what we're saying at Dahm & Rose is don't expect sort of the future outlook for export coal to be as strong as maybe the past couple months. So China's pulling back on the just a little bit, and that'll impact companies such as Canadian Pacific and Canadian National who go through the port of Vancouver.
All right, and there's another issue with coal, right? Because it's not just coal going to China, it's coal being displaced here by natural gas.
Absolutely. Well, you look, I mean, it's a multi-pronged issue with thermal coal here for the U.S. for electrical generation. I mean, one, demand, base demand is down as it is. The second thing, if you look at the burn for coal, well, that's being displaced by natural gas. And the third thing, stockpiles were high going into the summer, and we really had a mild summer. So don't expect too much out of North American demand for thermal coal.
All right. And that affects what's going on in the railroad business, right? Because
Absolutely.
You want to be careful if you're dependent on moving a lot of volume of coal. That's not going to happen.
No, it's not. And, you know, one of the quotes that we allude to in our most recent Track Work Weekly piece was that for the first time, some of the utility companies are actually seeing PRB coal, that's Powder River Basin
out of Wyoming,
right, being displaced by natural gas for burn. So usually, historically, that has been fairly insulated against natural gas fluctuations. But now it's just so low that you're seeing some of it be replaced.
All right. Let's just stick with the railroad industry just for a second. We're going to talk about trucking, but I want to ask you about Genesee and Wyoming, because they might make some acquisitions. They're trying to get their balance sheet in order, right? I mean, that's been something they've been working on. Might they make some acquisitions?
Well, Genesee recently did a secondary acquisition, and that was really to clean up the balance sheet, to prepare to sort of be on the acquisition warpath, if you will. You know, Genesee is one of these short line railroads, and they're one of the few really well capitalized short lines. I mean, they have about $300 million in available revolver capacity, and they have about $60 million in their balance sheet, and they're going to generate free cash flow this year.
That's been a big issue with them, is the free cash flow, right?
Right. They've been a great generator of free cash flow. And let's face it, right now, it's a buyer's market.
All right. What about GWR's stock price, Genesee, Wyoming? I mean, do we buy the stock now, or do we wait a little bit?
You know, I'd wait for a pullback, if you will. It's a very well-run company. It's a company that's constantly focused on returns and cash flow. So in the long run, investors should win out.
All right. Let's move over to the trucking industry, because a lot of interesting stuff going on there, because there are a lot of moving parts. Talk about Conway, but talk about it in the context of this. I don't want to say it. It's not heading into bankruptcy. And in fact, you've written a lot, but you've used that word when you talk about YRC. Is Conway taking market share from YRC?
Absolutely. And I would make the argument that in some cases, they're probably buying a little bit of market share from YRCW. See, when you look at the LTL game, per se, less than truckload.
Less than truckload.
It's really about pulling the right price/tonnage levers to get yourself the optimal operating profits to come out. And in some cases, discount a little bit to get some freight into your network actually work, because it's a high fixed cost network that Conway operates in. So Conway, if you look at the tonnage trends, you know, they were down at the beginning of the second quarter as much as 9%. They were about flat in July, and I think they're about up about 2-3% here in August.
How are they managing to do this? I mean, I know that they instituted a lot of cost control measures. That was back in March, but when they came out with their quarterly report, they just blew everybody away, right?
Well, absolutely. Well, it's the inherent leverage in the LTL model. You know, when you look the high fixed cost structure, you know, adding that additional skid to the back of the truck, the incremental margins are huge in the LTL business. So for Conway to go out and win the right business on the right trucks, that can make the world a difference. You add in the cost controls and really the integration of the three old Conway networks, and that was the result, I think, of the big quarterly beat. I'm a little leery about Conway in the near term in terms of meeting expectations, because says they have had to hire back a lot of additional workers to take on some of this freight. So there could be some short-term cost issues, but Conway's a great company. It's another good generator of cash, and they also have a very good truckload component that does business in Mexico. So I think in the long term, Conway's a good choice, but wait for it to pull back a little bit. It'll probably go under 40 in the near term.
And what about YRC Worldwide? What's the story there? I mean, are they going to end up in bankruptcy? Because they've gotten a lot of concessions from their workers. They've got changes in covenants. They look like they've got some money to at least last for a while. What's the story?
You know, we've written all year that we think Yellow's going to have a little bit longer life cycle than people believe, although it always is a tenuous situation. I mean, we entitled our latest note the 10th Amendment,
right?
Because it literally was the 10th Amendment from the banks. The stakeholders do not want Yellow to go under right now. That has been clear for what they're telling us. I think
the Teamsters, they don't want it to go under. They've made a lot of concessions. They would lose a lot of money.
Absolutely. Well, they'd lose a lot of jobs, and that's the big issue here. And I think if you look, the next step is going to be negotiating with the note holders. There's notes due in early 2010. These note holders are going to be subordinate to the bank debt. I believe they're going to probably work something out with the note holders. That'll be sort of the next hurdle Yellow's going to have to face.
All right. And if they do manage to jump over that hurdle, I mean, what do you do with the stock? I mean, is this a potential turnaround or is this long term?
You know, it's going to be tough, Pim, because they're still going to need the economy and also customers to come back. We really haven't seen that in any of the contacts that I have throughout the trucking industry. That's going to be a must. Yellow needs a lot of things to happen. Some of it are out of their control, but they're probably going to last a lot longer than people think, and there's always that outside shot that they do make it.
All right. I want to thank you very much, Jason Seidel, coming in from Dahman Roads, expert in the world of transports. I know you're running a big transport conference this week. Good luck with that, and thanks for sharing your insight into the industry group with us. Appreciate it.